That is wild. Oh, there it is. Oh my God.
The ocean wells, we cannot spill again. The dam may break, but nothing flows but hate.
It's a rainy day, everyone. 25, 30 knots of wind today. La Vaga is going to be all over the shop.
My two mates, Jimmy and Sam, flew over from Australia to come for a sail. They'd been on board once before in Europe and helped me sail throughout the Mediterranean, back when I thought that the barometer on the wall was using all of my power.
Good.
How you go?
I'm good. How are you?
I haven't changed from last night, so I didn't go out my shirt. My Vaga shirt.
Sam's so smooth in front of the camera, Elena. It's almost like he's not being filmed at all. What do you reckon about this idiot?
Big kid.
Nailed it. What do you think of the dairy over there? Is it a milk bar or just a corner store? It's a corner store.
Sailing tomorrow. What's the weather like there, Riley?
Classic New Zealand weather. Nightmare. I haven't dealt with red like that since I was in Crete, in Greece.
That's the Meltemi.
Let's
hit in.
That's what we were dealing with.
It's a movie day tomorrow.
Oh, I haven't even pressed play. Look at that. It gets dark down there. That's filthy weather.
Cyclone Tracy.
How's that vegetarian pizza there, Riley?
Fair enough.
I still don't believe me about the vegetarianness.
Today we plan to provision the boat and take care of a few jobs on La Vagabonde so we could set sail to Great Barrier the following morning, as soon as this weather had cleared up.
No fish, put it back. That's meat. No need to cry.
See you. See you next week, mate. Love you.
It's a vegan ship. Riley's changed. What's your views on that shopping experience, Riley?
You ready to go, mate?
I think we've got enough food for a month.
Getting
mangoes
there.
In the nets?
Yeah, why not?
Cold.
Are they cold?
They're cold at the moment.
Maybe fridge.
So what last
thing? Now hang on, mate, come here. Now what happened? You're a bit camera shy, aren't you?
Yes.
What happened, mate?
I lost my passport.
Whereabouts?
And computer and iPad.
And there's been a big panic over the last few days. The Novotel was on DEFCON 4.
There wasn't a panic. So we found it this morning. It was handed in. Lost and found. Auckland Airport. Thanks, guys.
Shout out to Auckland Airport.
Riley is just about to do the crazy on the outboard. Jeez. What are you trying to do? Oh, don't do it. Don't do it.
You need some help?
Nah, I've got two mates here, but
you have no security line, eh?
I know.
Uh-huh.
Don't try that, babe. It looks ridiculous. Oh. Oh my God. Oh my God. How or why you do that? Is your back okay?
Yeah.
That doesn't hurt your back?
That doesn't hurt my back.
What does it hurt?
Everything else.
What are you doing there, Jimmy?
We're repairing a little tender. Found a little hole. So. A little pinprick, but Ollie says he's got to pump it up every day.
Yeah, it's been very annoying.
Yes.
Sad looking little tender.
It's not pretty.
We never said we were boat mechanics.
Are you watching the 45 Matthew?
Watching my video again.
13.7.
It's got 250,000 views now. The boat is built for extended cruising. I think I'm solely responsible for about a quarter of that.
I think so.
This is Matt Chew, he's my best mate.
It's the Chew! Are narrow, so as to enhance the hydrodynamic. Handsome man, Matt Chew. Which is also improved by the bowman. 5:50. We're all making coffees and we're about to head off to catch the bridge. We booked in this morning for 6:30 to 6:45, so we've got to get a move on. But coffee first. Good morning, everyone.
Morning, Elena.
Riley's brushing his hair.
Yeah, very busy morning
on the coffee bridge.
Fungaray Bridge Control, La Vagabonde.
Bridge Control, La Vagabonde,
go ahead. We understand that you're opening the bridge up at 6:30, quarter to 7, is that correct?
That's correct, yes, I'm down here now, I'm expecting another vessel coming from the seaward side, and we'll see if we can get to both at once.
Excellent, we've left the town basin to be up 2 minutes ago, so we'll see you very soon.
This is Bridge Control,
bridge
will be opening in 2 minutes. Please move beyond the
barriers. Oh, I hear some noises.
Here we go.
Cool.
It was a pretty nippy morning until the first few rays of sun came out for the day. We were pretty excited to sail to Great Barrier Island because we'd heard that this place is like what New Zealand used to be like 30 years ago. With less than 900 people living there year round, generators for power and houses buried in the trees with vegetable gardens, sounded like our kind of place. It was only about 55 nautical miles southeast of Whangarei. Riley's addicted to editing now. Yeah, it'll be to the left of us now.
Right in front of us.
Oh, there it is!
It's the same one.
We had to turn the stinking engine on because there's no wind. It's very glassy this afternoon and we are, what, half an hour away? I think.
Not even that.
Not even that. It is stinking, I hate the engine. Did Jimmy just beat you in a game of chess?
Yeah. I beat him in just the bust. It's a bit of a sore point. We're not really talking about it at the moment.
One all, we're even. Game three soon.
Decision to grab a mooring ball in this little anchorage, so we didn't film any of it, but here we are next to Aldo, who's clearly not on his boat. We yelled out to ask him if we could take this mooring, but we're not sure. I guess we'll soon find out. Well, already on the job.
So if you make sure you've got, I'm fine, Jimmy. Sam,
Have you got hold of one end of that rope?
The very end of the blue rope.
The very end of the blue rope. Yeah. No, it's just because otherwise it'll pull your arm off when you throw it.
Yeah, yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
1, 2.
With some strong southerly winds inbound for the area over the next few days, Port Fitzroy would be our little hideout, where we were about as protected as it gets. Sammy and I have just taken the tender to shore. We're going to find the road. Oh! I think I just saw an eel. Right. Well, it's a ghost town.
I have chainsaw skills and also have been working as a...
I have chainsaw skills.
I'm reliable.
I don't trust him. It's a ghost town. I haven't seen a person yet. Can't speak properly. I'm that puffed. Whew. Riles has had a shave. One touch. Bueno.
Is it symmetrical? Some people have written in and said you need to tighten up on that stash, mate.
Well, the stash? It looks pretty even to me. It looks like a whale tail.
This is such a nice spot. I had best day coming out here. I've got my two mates here and we are in a fantastic location. How nice is this place?
Yeah, very nice.
Chin chin.
Sammy?
It's a tough life.
Are you naked?
Yeah, well I was. Hello?
Yep.
10 out of 10.
Brown teals are amongst the rarest ducks in the world and are considered nationally vulnerable. Piatoa is home to almost two-thirds of the Romanian population. They are mainly active at night but can commonly be seen foraging along estuaries and the water's edge during the day. They are extremely vulnerable to predation and are often hit by cars on the road and at night. Please take care when driving. See you, boys.
You know you're in a good anchorage when you can see the white caps off in the distance, but you're in about 4 knots of wind, Sammy.
Even if we were blowing its ass off from here, you wouldn't get much.
We only expect the best from you, Riley.
Just listen up, Riley. We've got a few things to teach you. You get that.
You get that.
What have you got for dinner, guys?
Are they refried? Beans. It's a burrito.
Nice.
It's going to be amazing.
Damn. Thanks, Riles.
No worries, fellas. It was quite easy. Even when you're rinsing
water, you get rid of it.
I signed up.
Yeah, no,
Nicargo. Given up on Bananagram. It takes too long. We decided to get away from all the intense insect noises in the anchorage and spent the next few days hiking and exploring this beautiful island of Great Barrier. How's the water?
It's not too bad.
We visited the Katoke Hot Springs, a place where hot water from a deep underground reservoir slides up a fault line crack nearby. These hot springs have been used for bathing and good health by Great Barrier Island locals and guests since human time began in these parts. The water is high in sulphur and silver content, which is said to have medicinal properties.
Oh my
my gosh, it's really hot.
It's hot. Turned around and look what she's doing. I knew you were going to do that.
Leave me alone. This creek reminds me a lot of the creek I used to have in my backyard in Ithaca, between Northampton and Geraldton, if there's anyone from there. It used to be one of my favourite little hangouts when I was a young'un, except unlike New Zealand, there was lots of spiders and snakes, so we had to be very careful. And foxes. The foxes used to eat all of our chickens and our turkeys and our pigs. They ate everything.
What are you on
about? I was just saying how that creek reminds me of the creek that used to be in my backyard when I was little. Definitely not as green though. So green. It's actually Australia Day. We found ourselves in a pub and we are playing darts and the loser has to clean the hull, which I would have rather bet money on because the water's freezing and it's murky and the hull's really dirty. Again, it's been in that marina. Anyway, it's Australia Day
and
it's party time. We are the only ones here.
Oh, double 17, 34, and 12, so yeah.
Okay, we're listening to the Triple J Hottest 100 countdown on a mobile phone.
We're streaming at 4G. The whole joint's just lit up with 4G. I love New Zealand.
Yeah. Just heard Violent Soho. Happy as Larry.
Yes, sir. Once you get back to the boat.
This is a serious ride home. I've nearly died twice.
You got the music?
Jim,
don't rock the boat.
Keep your head down. You're just another fool in the crowd. Happy Australia Day.
Yeah.
Ciao.
Oh, it looks shallow. I reckon we'll make it though. Oh, that's real shallow. That's wicked.
That's pretty sick, out.
That's so cool.
You'd be better off. Stop rocking around here.
Sammy, stop trying to fall in the water.
Tie a bowline in your end of it.
Super early in the morning. We are motoring back to Auckland. It's about 60 nautical miles.
And
blue. Everything's blue.
Main-tail heli.
Weird. How are you this morning, babe?
Good. Always getting up. It's a nice time of day. Feels like a bit of an adventure. Can you untie that rope, Jimmy?
Engine's on.
Quite a knot.
Neutral. Much better than this. We've got about 10 knots of wind, about 60 degrees, and no swell, which is awesome. And we're sitting on about 5 knots, headed directly on course to Auckland. So yeah, we'll be sailing all day, but I'm not complaining.
Right about now, the spinnaker would have been absolutely perfect. However, we left it at our mate Graham's house in the Bay of Islands to make room for the millions of guests we've had on board since we arrived at the oh-so-convenient New Zealand.
Wanna know if you
just watch that rope. We've all put our groovy pants on.
You should go halves with those.
I got the sequins.
You get so offended. I look
and we're going dancing. Thanks for watching, everyone. Please join us next week. We have a meet and greet in New Zealand, which is a lot of fun, and we also pack up La Vagabonde once and for all because we're moving to France. So it's a very emotional but exciting week for us. I hope you've been enjoying catching up to real time with the massive episodes. Should be back to normal from now on. Cheers, see you next week.